Hi, I'm Barbara Ray. I'm here in our London office and had the pleasure today of talking with Claire Barham about her experience in building global business services teams in life sciences and consumer goods.
My name's Claire Barham. I'm a global business services transformation specialist. I've worked both within management consulting and within industry in areas like consumer goods industry. I've been recently at Unilever, life sciences, both AstraZeneca and GSK, some retail. And really, I've done a lot of work taking clients from the starting point of their global business services journey right the way through to implementation. So all different stages of life cycle of change.
So if you were giving advice to an executive who's about to undergo a transformation, whether it's the development of a global business mm-hmm. services strategy, you know, or putting that in place in their organization or some other sort of transformation, what would be the things you'd say they can't miss?
A number of things. I think where a lot of companies go wrong is they try and do too much change at once. And they just pile transformation program on top of transformation program. You know, and I talk a lot to clients and both inside organizations around prioritization. You know, there's only so much change an organization can take at once, and if they keep piling it on, it gets diluted. And I think people underestimate the importance of stakeholder buy-in. Mm. So before you really start, there's no point forcing change on an organization, and that's where I've mainly seen it go wrong, where companies embark on these programs but haven't spent the time up front really invested in that stakeholder buy-in.
How have you seen organizations either not balance that well or balance that well with the demands of right now, but recognizing that it has to be incremental to be successful?
So I'll give you an example. I was brought into one of the a life sciences organization that needed to change their finance organization. And on my first day, I went around all the different members of the finance leadership team and I said, I'm here to change the finance operating model. Why? And they all gave me a different answer. And I said, and what's most important? And they all gave me a different answer. And, you know, really had to unpack what's the reason for the change, what's most important,
right,
so that we could stagger that change in the right sort of way. We could order the change in the right way. You know, what's the most important driver for this? What do we do? People can get fatigued with change. They can get very bored. If you can roadmap the transformation appropriately, you can do your plan so that people see incremental changes, can see some wins on the board. That generates buy-in to the program itself. It's actually a really interesting point around the whole global business services space, because your team there is made up of often finance people, procurement leaders, HR leaders, all of whom kind of have two roles. They have their role within the GBS leadership team, but then they have their accountability back to their function. And it can be a really challenging place to get that team adhered to, because the HR person in the room wants to do the best for the HR delivery, the finance person in the room wants the finance. Right. So you find the team is kind of fighting for their own goals rather than a joined up goal. So I've spent a lot of time really trying to invest in what's that joined up vision. And I think it's really talking about what the role GBS, Global Business Services, has for the organization. How does that help them deliver the strategy? What's the power of them coming together?
How have you seen that work?
I think, again, just spending time together. You know, I introduced something at a consumer goods company I was working at recently. We did quarterly performance reviews. Mm. So once a quarter, 2 to 3 days in a room together, what are we going to achieve over the next quarter? How are we going to prioritize that? What's the impact on the organization? What do we need from a resources point of view? What's that going to do for our team? Working those questions through together, making sure people understand what everyone else is trying to achieve. And what they need to achieve that. You know, right. The danger in most situations is everyone goes off and tries to do everything and they don't have the resourcing to do that. So coming together to make those joined up decisions using clear criteria around impact on the organization, I think helps.
Thank you so much for being here.
My pleasure.